story for us.
So, Miles, you worked inside the National Security Establishment as Chief of Staff at the Department of Homeland Security. This morning, we learned that despite the cries from the president and his supporters and an entire television network for years that something untoward was happening in the Obama administration about unmasking. Unmasking is asking for names to be unredacted in intelligence documents. There was an investigation by the Justice Department. The Washington Post reports this morning they didn't find anything illegal, no criminal charges. They're not even going to write a report. Nothing to see here. What's your takeaway from this morning?
Well, I said this to someone yesterday and said it online. This really shows that the president of the United States has a pretty tortured relationship with masks. And we're not just talking about his unwillingness to wear masks with COVID-19. He's been so hyper-focused on this practice of unmasking. But I'll tell you, as a former national security official, this is a very common practice. What happens is you might get very sensitive intelligence information regarding very serious threats to the United States. And usually, and appropriately, the intelligence community redacts the names of U.S. officials and U.S. organizations. But if it's something serious that needs to be followed up on, oftentimes you might need to put in a request to find out who that individual was. There's a disciplined process for that, one that includes transparency, oversight, internal checks and balances, because you don't want the names of U.S. individuals to be in intelligence that officials see all the time. But people follow that process so that they can make sure that Americans are protected. But again, there's oversight and transparency in that process. So what I believe that John Bash found, who was investigating this, was there was nothing wrong here, and that this was all bluster on behalf of the press.